Hey guys, welcome back to part 2 of our Endless Runner game tutorial series. Alright, let's open up the project in Unreal Engine and navigate to the content browser. Create a new folder called Animations within the Runner folder. Next, exit Unreal Engine and download the animations from the link provided in the description below. Now, open the project folder in File Explorer and locate the Content, Runner and then Animations folder. Open another window in File Explorer and navigate to the folder where you saved the animation files. Copy the 2.uasset files and paste them into the Animations folder in File Explorer. Once done, go back to the main project folder and open the project in Unreal Engine. You should now see the two animation files in the Animations folder. If you encounter an error, it might be because you're using an older version of the engine or you don't have the UE5 mannequin. If you're using a custom character, you'll need to download the .fbx files and retarget them, which will be covered in an upcoming video. Next, let's navigate to the Blueprints folder and create a new character blueprint named BP_runner_character. Right-click and select Input from the section, then choose Input Mapping Content and name it IMC_runner_default. Save the Input Mapping Content and open up the character blueprint. In the viewport, select the mesh and choose either SKM_Manny or SKM_Quinn for the skeletal mesh asset. In the animation blueprint, select your preferred character animation blueprint. Adjust both the location and rotation in the Z-axis to -90. Now, select the capsule component and add a spring arm, name it Camera Boom. Then, select the spring arm and add a camera, name it Follow Camera. Select the spring arm and adjust the target arm length to 400. Move it up in the Z-axis to the character's head, and rotate it -10 degrees in the Y-axis. In the event graph, delete the event actor begin overlap node. At the event begin play, right-click and add get controller. Connect the return value to cast a player controller and connect execution pins to the event begin play. As player controller, add enhanced input subsystem and add an isValid node. Select the one with the question mark symbol. Connect the execution pins of the player controller. From the return value of the enhanced input, add another node called addMappingContext, connect the execution pins. And select IMC_runner_default from the mapping context drop-down menu. Select all those nodes and press C to add a comment named addInputMapping. Move to the event tick, right-click, and add Get Control Rotation. From the return value, add Break Rotator, and from the Z, add Make Rotator. While holding Control, change the node connecting to the X-axis to the Z-axis. From the return value of the Make Rotator, add Get Forward Vector, and then add movement input. Connect the execution pins. Select all those nodes and press C to add a comment named infinite run. Compile and save the blueprint. Now, let's go back to the content browser. Right-click and select input from the section, then choose input action. Name it jump_ia and duplicate it twice to have a total of 3 input actions. Name the duplicate slide_ia and move_ia. Save all the input actions. Open move_ia and change the value type to vector2d. Save it. Open IMC_runner default and add an action mapping. Choose jump underscore IA and add a control binding and by clicking the keyboard icon and pressing W or space. You can add multiple bindings if needed. Add another action mapping and select slide underscore IA. Add a control binding and by clicking the keyboard icon and pressing S. Add another action mapping and select move underscore IA. Add two control bindings, choosing A and D keys. For the A binding, add modifiers and select negate. Save it. Now, go to the character blueprint and right-click to add the jump underscore IA as an input action node. From the triggered pin, add the jump function. Select all the nodes and press C to add a comment named jump. Compile and save. In the viewport, add a player start from the place actors window. Additionally, open the runner game mode in the content browser and change the default pawn to BP underscore runner character. Compile and save. Now, open the level viewport and click play. As you can see, the character runs automatically, and when we press space, the character jumps. Press shift plus escape to exit the game. Now, let's go back to the character blueprint. Right-click and add slide underscore IA as an input action node. Drag the character movement from the components tab and add impulse. Change the Z scale to -1000 and check the velocity change. Connect the execution pins. Compile and save. Go back to the main viewport and press play. Now, when we press the slide button while mid-air, the character immediately comes down with force. Exit the game. Open the character blueprint and duplicate the character movement node in the event graph. Add get velocity. And vector length nodes. Add a greater than node and change the value to 60. From the character movement, add an is falling node. Add a not boolean node from the return value of the is falling node. From the second pin of the not boolean node, add the in boolean node. Hold control and drag the first pin to the second one and connect the return value of the greater than node to the and boolean. From the return value of the and boolean, add a branch node and connect the execution pins. From the true pin, add a do once node. And then add disable input node. Drag the capsule component from the components tab and add a set collision response to channel node. Set the channel to destructible and the new response to ignore. Drag the mesh component from the components tab and add a get anim instance node. From the return value, add a montage play node. Select the running underscore slide montage and set the play rate to 1.5. Add a delay of 0.7. Create a new variable called isSliding and set its type to Boolean. Then, drag the variable and connect it to the execution pin of the setCollision node, and check the isSliding node. Copy the three nodes, capsule component, setCollision, setIsSliding, and paste them after the delay. Change the new response in the set collision node to block. And uncheck the is sliding node by unticking the box. Then, add an enable input node between the set collision node and the is sliding node. Connect the execution pin of the is sliding node to the reset pin of the do once node we added earlier. Select all the nodes and press C to add a comment named sliding. Compile and save the character blueprint. Now, open the level and press play to see that we can slide. However, you may notice that the character's feet are not animating properly. This issue is due to the IK system. To fix it, exit the game. In the content browser, navigate to Character's Mannequin Animations and select the animation blueprint of your character. In the anim graph, disconnect the control rigs. Compile and save the animation blueprint. Now, when you press the slide button, you'll see that it works properly. That's it for today's video. In the next video, we'll focus on adding the floor and obstacles. Stay tuned for more exciting updates in our Endless Runner game tutorial series. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. See you in the next video.